Facebook is once again making headlines after Apple said one of Facebook's apps is in violation of its terms of policy. Since 2016, Facebook has been paying users $20 a month plus referral fees to sell their phone usage data via the Facebook Research app. Facebook says it had users' permission and that less than 5% of the app users were teenagers. Joining us now to talk more about all this is tech analyst Ryan Eldridge from Nerds on Call. Ryan, appreciate you being with us today. Help me understand, why is Facebook taking so much heat for pushing this data collection app? I mean, users, they gave their permission, right?
Yeah, they did. And it's kind of into the weeds, a little inside baseball here. Essentially, Facebook had an app a while ago called Anavo. And when Apple discovered that it was collecting user data the same way they are now, Apple said, nope, can't have that in our platform anymore. You need to take that down. And they did. But they have a second app that's called Facebook Research that they were distributing through three other companies. And they're running ads on Snapchat, and they were running ads on Instagram and other platforms trying to get teenagers to sign up, specifically targeting in those ads teenagers from between 13 and 17 years old. Mm-hmm. Now, in the sign-up process, they were relatively clear about what they were going to be doing and they were asking for parental permission. But I don't know exactly how clear they were. Facebook didn't make it clear that it was Facebook that was targeting these teenagers. Uh-huh. It was just these companies, and you didn't find out it was Facebook until after you began the sign-up process.
And so help me understand here, because Apple basically, as sort of punishment, is they're pulling Facebook's what's called their enterprise certificate. So yes. Explain exactly how Facebook violated Apple's rules.
So in a normal world, you would develop an app and you'd put it on the Apple Store, and then Apple would say, yep, this is a good app, we'll accept it, and they'll put it in for mass distribution to the public. Well, for developers, they can't wait through all that process, and they especially want to be able to test their apps on iOS devices within their company. And that's when Apple created this program so people like Facebook and Google and others can develop apps, distribute it through their company, do user testing, make sure everything's working okay before they release it to the store. But they're supposed to be using it only amongst employees and on campuses. What they're using it for here is they're actually distributing it to non-employees, in fact, paying people for market research, mm-hmm. and that violates Apple's policies.
Okay, so what is the impact for Facebook moving forward here?
Well, Facebook has said that they're going to take the app off of the iOS platform, but they're still going to have it on Android, which, of course, runs nearly 80% of the mobile
right.
market. So it's just a small drop in the bucket to take it off of Apple. Google today also came out saying that they have their same kind of app, but you have to be 18 or over for you to use the survey app. Mm-hmm. And they've also decided to take it off of Apple's iOS.
Really, it just seems like another hit for Facebook, obviously, you know, facing so many questions about privacy and what's happening with our information. Just another blow to them, really.
Yeah, and this app was giving access to things from photos to instant message chats to emails, virtually entire access to the phone, where the phone was.
Yeah.
And it's not really clear how exact Facebook was in revealing that information to the users as they were signing up.
Yeah, kind of scary to think you would voluntarily turn over all that information for, what is it, 20 bucks a month?
Yeah, 20 bucks.
I might need some more money. All right, Ryan Eldridge from Nerds on Call. Appreciate it. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Okay, I know that.